What we have here is all the component parts for getting started cooking some eggs. Still trying to find the right combination of thyme and acid to give me what I need. I trust everybody can see what we start with. These eggs are salmon eggs that have been treated to keep them preserved, but not cooked. These eggs, same eggs, they spent 5 minutes in a bath of 4 cups of water and 20 milliliters of acid. These did the same thing, and then I double dipped them once more. And what I ended up here, finally, is an egg that holds the hook. The unfortunate thing is, it lost the color. Totally different. But that'll stay on the hook. And quite frankly, I've caught fish with these eggs. And it does juice a little bit as well. Now these closer to the color, which is where I want to go, but they just don't have the staying power on the hook. When you drive a hook in there, the egg explodes too much. So what I'm trying to accomplish is to take that second batch into acid again for a period of time, maintain the color, and come out with a tougher egg. If you saw the other video, you know that this is the egg cure that I use to take raw eggs to make them cured eggs. Basically, you make a brine, mix up in a gallon jug, soak them, and then take cured eggs, the cooked eggs, muriatic acid. The secret, of course, is what the heck is the mixture? How much acid, how much water, how long time? And we'll put 5 or 6 eggs in here. We're going to drop them in 3 cups of water, 10 milliliters of acid. I'm going to run the stopwatch on them for 5 minutes. We're going to take them out. We're then going to take those eggs, rinse them off good, and see how they do as far as color and the ability to stay on the hook. I mean, these kind of, if I could get these eggs to stay on the hook, then there'd be no need really to have any more discussion about process. But it's not happening. Can't do it, and I don't know why. Now, some suggestions I've received is you take these eggs and you put them in a 10-to-1 solution, 10 parts water, 1 part acid, for X number of seconds, and you end up then with an egg that looks good, fishes good, milks good. I have yet to pull that off. Whenever I try that, I end up with something that's a little bit more opaque as opposed to being translucent. Doesn't have the milking properties. In fact, sometimes it gels up on me to the point where they're almost hard. So I have to stop that. But rather than sit here and watch these eggs cook, I'm gonna check this time. We've only got 1.5 minutes in the bath. I'm hoping we can get some kind of a cooked egg here in a couple minutes, so I'll shut down. Okay. Water bath. That's the only thing that could be metal. Everything else comes in contact with the acid's got to be plastic. Or glass. I don't want a 4-ounce glass, so plastic's fine. So that's 4 minutes, 4.5. We're coming up on 5. I'm not quite sure if it has to be precisely 5 minutes, but stopwatch helps you remember. Last thing you want to do is throw them in there and forget what time you put them in. Okay, they've been soaking in there 5 minutes. Put these buggers in the water. Stop the cooking process. See what we got up. How did this? All right, we didn't lose too much of the color, but you can see, just from a little extra time in the acid, these eggs are starting to get a little bit more opaque than they were before. So the more time they spend in the acid, the less translucent. The more time they spend in the acid, the more firm they become. So that's not a bad color. Let's see what it looks like as far as a hook hold. That's not too bad. It didn't explode like the last time, but quite frankly, I don't think I'm going to get more than a cast or two out of these things. So, at this point in time, the only decision is, do I want to stay with what I've got, try fishing these eggs, or do I want to try to firm them up? And so the jury's still out on this, but if I can get that egg and I can keep it on that hook to make a half a dozen casts, and it's going to milk out like it does, that isn't too bad. And then shaking it at this table and throwing it across the stream is two different things. But it holds pretty good and it milks good. So if you're looking for an option, here's what you got. Raw eggs. Raw eggs spent 5 minutes in a bath. It was four parts water, 20 milliliters of acid, 5 minutes rinsed, put in the fridge. I took them out and they look like this. I try to double dip these puppies in another bath. 3 cups of water, 10 milliliters, a little bit weaker solution. Trying to toughen them up, but not turn them into this, which is a little bit too dark and I lose that any kind of a translucent look to them. I don't like that. They aren't bad eggs though, but just don't like it. The next thing I'm gonna do is I've doubled the acid. We're 20 milliliters, 3 cups of water. We're gonna try the same deal. We're gonna throw a small quantity of these eggs in that acid for 5 minutes, which is, that bath, twice as much acid. And see if we can get some eggs we can be happy with. So back to the stopwatch. Back in the bath, we're going to give them 5 minutes, see what we come up with. I mean, when I talk to guys about how they do their eggs, everybody's got kind of a different way of doing it. But you literally have to come up with the right solution. Just resetting my ticker. There we go. Just counting down again. Okay. Like I said, stronger solution, same amount of time. Trying to maintain some translucent look to them without losing all the hardness that becomes so hard that it won't milk. These eggs actually feel a lot better than these. You can tell when you pick them up that they're mushy. These are a little bit more firm. If anybody out there has a better idea on what I've got, man, I am ready to listen. because I really don't know the answer to what the right mix should be. I've talked to guys that say that they use a coffee can of eggs, raw eggs. They throw in a cap full of acid and they leave it in there for a period of time and they take the eggs out and test them. It just doesn't sound like it's strong enough for me. I mean, I don't know. Again, that acid basically is burning the skin of this thing and toughening it up. But if it goes too far, it cooks the egg the whole way through and then it's worthless. So, let me back in a couple of minutes. All right, these eggs have been in here about 5 minutes. Get them out of the acid. And again, the acid was 3 cups of water, 20 milliliters. Acid, 5 minutes. Trying to see if we can improve on the toughness of this egg without getting rid of the color that's in it. By the way, this milliliter stuff, cough medicine. You know, the little caps that come with the cough medicine, they all got milliliters marked on them, so that's the, instead of teaspoons for the kids, you're giving them, for the adults, you're giving them milliliters. So you can easily figure out exactly what you're putting in this stuff by having some of the cough medicine caps. I gotta tell you, they don't look any worse for the wear of being in a stronger acid. In fact, they look about the same. So twice as strong, same amount of water, got a nice firmness to it. I can't notice a whole lot of difference. Just don't know for sure whether to say that one or the other is a better way to go. But again, we're going to test this thing. What we want to do is we want to have an egg that's got about the same color that it started with, still maintains the fact that it's a little translucent rather than getting opaque like this one here that's been cooked too long. And you sure don't want it to turn total white if you drop it in strong acid. A super strong solution of acid will do that. Let's see what we got. Number 16 hook. Nice pop of juice comes out. So it didn't cook through any more in that stronger acid. I think it's going to stay on the hook pretty good. So what I would do then is I would go with 3 cups of water, 20 milliliters of acid for the second bath on an egg that I had put in originally 4 cups of water, 20 milliliters of acid. That gives me a nice firm egg. Even after I take it off the hook, it's still firm. You got to maintain that firmness to it. So that wasn't bad. Wasn't bad at all. So now that I get, by the way, when you're going through the eggs after you've cooked them a little bit, and you start getting some of these losers that look like they lose that round shape to them, those are throwaways. Get them out of your box. You're going to get rid of those. These are a little bit softer. Again, these were the ones in the weaker solution. They got a nice bubble coming up out of it too. I'm not quite sure if I can get this up, if it's going to screw up, whether it's going to be in focus or not, but you can see a little bubble of juice coming up. You want that bleed because you have to have that to provide the scent in the water that still had or attracted to the egg. They're going to come to it by its shape, its size, its color, but that little bit of scent really, that's the difference between artificial eggs and real eggs. I like that. That wasn't bad at all. So these are the ones that I had previously cooked that, quite frankly, I told you, at this point, in 4 cups of water, 20 milliliters of acid for 5 minutes the first time around, it basically explodes. You can't fish that. There's just absolutely no way. So you got to put more acid to them. And you do that to make it tougher, hold the hook, but you try to do that without losing what you're trying to accomplish as far as translucent in color. So it's possible to do it. What I'm going to do is throw the rest of the eggs that I had. I'm going to go with the 3 cups, 20 milliliters, second time around. I think that's a better bath form for 5 minutes. That's going to give me a nice container of these eggs for the next time I go fishing. The other thing I want to see that I've known that's happened in the past is that after you cook eggs, when you keep them in the fridge for a period of time, I'm not sure if the egg continues to cook or if it just over time hardens more. But sometimes these eggs will sit in the fridge for a period of time and you go down and that what started off as being good juicy eggs as far as pricking with a hook, they turn into gel inside. Totally screws up the value of the eggs. But we'll have to wait and see. I'm going to do a small container of them. I've got lots of these fresh eggs. I am not going to fool these around. I'm going to use this smaller container of eggs, give them a bath, and get ready for the next time I go fishing. So, what we're going to do, just take these. Now, because I'm using more eggs, I'm not going to use this little strainer. Instead, going to throw them all in the big bath. But I think there's more than enough solution in there to take care of it. There's one of those loser eggs right on top. He's already white the whole way through. Basically, it's a broken egg. Just weed those puppies out. He'll float up to the top in the acid bath anyhow. No good. Another one down here. No good. Worthless. Now these, good to go. All right. Stop watching. All zeros. Hit the timer. They're in for 5 minutes. Give them a stir once in a while. 5 minutes isn't that long. Again, this is the second time they've been in a bath. Let's see how they come out. All right, that big batch, bigger batch, is about ready to come out. Gonna have to pour them through a stringer because I can't fish them out. I'm waiting for that time to get closer to 5 minutes. I don't think it has to be precise, but just a good idea to try to do it the same way each time, then you'll know. Five minutes in the bath. And we'll put them in here. Rinse them off. See what we come up with. I gotta tell you that they sound better. They sound a little more firm when they went in, so I know the acid did its job. Now if I was going to rinse these things, I think I'd do a little bit better job rinsing them than I am, but there's the finished product. There's some in there floating around. I'll let them there for now. But raw eggs, you get a little bit better look at them when you see them against that white spoon. Give you a chance to see what they look like and how translucent they are. My wife said, because I'm colorblind, that's sort of a golden color. So, golden translucent color. Raw eggs. Go through that egg cure. This is egg cured eggs. Be in the fridge for months. And I take the egg cure eggs, and I started them. 4 cups of water, 20 milliliters of acid, 5 minutes first time around. Took them out. And after a period of time, I go back in and do a second one. Now, I guess it stands to reason that you could leave, if you're going to do 20 milliliters for 5 minutes each time, why not just do them 10? Because I've actually changed the solution from 4 to 20 milliliters to 3 cups to 20, and then cooked them a second time. And you see, the color does not look bad compared to where they started. And the ability for this to stay on the hook compared to that is night and day. This thing you can cast across the Elk Creek and it's going to stay on the hook. And it's juicing so that the fish can smell it. So they can see it, they can smell it. it should be a good bait. Now, the one thing I don't know, and the only thing that will answer that question, is time. When I take these things and put them in the container and put them back in the fridge and go down there a week later, what are they going to look like? Or what are they going to feel like, and more importantly? I don't think they're going to get any darker. I'm not going to put any solution with them. I'm just going to keep them in there dry. They were dry on the table. So I got a feeling they're going to be just fine as far as using for single eggs. And I'd be happy to fish those anywhere. But you know how it is. Everything I've said about single eggs in the past I thought was true. And I keep revising the way I do things because I'm still looking for the better way to get it done. And I think double dipping these eggs, at least the eggs I have right now, seem to work better than going with stronger solution, shorter periods of time, less water. It's what works best for me. So you can give it a try and come up with a better method. Hey, drop me a note. I'm always interested in finding out something new. Thanks for watching.